I've been planning on making this video for a while now. Not anytime soon, but somewhere down the line. But last Friday on May 14th, hardcore wrestling legend and absolute madman Jerome Young, aka New Jack, passed away at 58. And in the wake of his passing, he's been on my mind a lot, and I feel like it's an appropriate time to pay my respects to him. New Jack is probably the most infamous professional wrestler of all time. Well, besides, you know. New Jack has earned himself titles like the most feared wrestler of all time and wrestling's most violent man, and that's not just a gimmick. New Jack is infamous for ditching the theatrics of wrestling and turning it into real-life violence, but I think to truly understand why New Jack was the most feared man in wrestling and why he became this way, you have to have a better understanding of his youth. Jerome Young was born on January 3rd, 1963 in Greensboro, North Carolina. When Jerome was 5 years old in 1968, he witnessed his father stabbing his mother multiple times after she had come home from work because a friend of his called him and told him that he saw her in a car with somebody else. Apparently, Jerome's mother had cheated on his father multiple times with multiple different people. 5 months later, when Jerome's mother tried to take him away from his father, he shot her in the leg. Jerome's father was an alcoholic and died of a heart attack a couple months after this traumatic event in young Jerome's life. In an interview with Vlad TV, New Jack said that after his father died, his mother would be bringing new men into the house every night to sleep with, and he, quote, just wanted to get the fuck out of there. He also mentioned that his mother would beat the shit out of him for no reason, and himself and his mother didn't get along for the rest of his life. When New Jack was in his senior year of high school, he went to prison for 2 years for armed robbery and aggravated assault. It isn't hard to see, after having such a rough time in his youth, how New Jack became one of the most legitimately dangerous people in a form of entertainment that is not supposed to be dangerous. After getting released from jail, Young worked as a truck driver and then worked as a bounty hunter for 10 years, a job he seemed to enjoy very much, no doubt because of its confrontational and occasionally violent nature. Young was in this line of work until a friend approached him with the idea of becoming a professional wrestler. Young was hesitant at first, but once he met his future trainer Ray Candy, and Candy told him that he could make a lot of money in this line of work, he was all in. Jerome Young got the name New Jack from the 1991 film New Jack City. New Jack began wrestling in the United States Wrestling Association and won the USWA tag team belts with his tag team partner Homeboy. But New Jack didn't really make a name for himself in the world of pro wrestling until he started working for Jim Cornette in his promotion Smoky Mountain Wrestling. Here is where New Jack formed his wrestling crew called the Gangstas. See, New Jack was playing a bad guy in Smoky Mountain, but not just a normal cartoony wrestling bad guy. He was playing a black wrestling bad guy who hated white people. My absolute favorite thing New Jack did during his time as a bad guy in Smoky Mountain Wrestling was cut a promo where he gave a special shout out to his homeboy OJ Simpson and told him to keep up the good work. He finished the statement by saying, "Now there's two less to worry about." Of course, talking about OJ allegedly killing his ex-wife Nicole Brown Simpson and Ron Goldman.
I'd like to send a special shout out to my homeboy OJ Simpson. Keep up the good work, baby. Two less we got to worry about. You understand? Keep up the good work. Louis Farrakhan will be the next president. Snoop Dogg. We know you're innocent. You called me last night.
This promo caused such an uproar at the time that New Jack and his tag team partner had to be escorted to and from the building where they were wrestling by the police. New Jack playing this anti-white character to professional wrestling fans from the South obviously resulted in the crowd screaming at New Jack, calling him the N-word, something New Jack had a problem with at first but changed his perspective on quickly. New Jack had this change in perspective when veteran wrestler Ricky Morton told him that if he can piss the crowd off to the point where they scream the N-word at him, then he's doing his job right. Time passed and New Jack's star was on the rise. Eventually he signed with ECW, and this is where New Jack really made a name for himself, for all the wrong reasons. If you don't know, ECW stands for Extreme Championship Wrestling, and they specialized in hardcore wrestling. I'm talking about guys going through burning tables, the ropes of the ring being replaced with barbed wire, and lots of blood. And nobody was as legitimately hardcore as New Jack. On November 23rd, 1996, in Revere, Massachusetts, New Jack was involved in the mass transit incident. This was when New Jack and his tag team partner were meant to face wrestlers who could not make it to the show for reasons that were never disclosed. So instead of facing the opponents he was scheduled to face, he ended up wrestling Eric Koulis, a 17-year-old boy who was not trained to be a professional wrestler, who had convinced booker Paul Heyman that he was a 22-year-old man and trained by pro wrestling veteran Killer Kowalski. Koulis went by the ring name Mass Transit and requested that New Jack blade him during the match. For those not familiar with pro wrestling lingo, blade means to secretly use a small razor on their opponent during a match so that they bleed, to give the fans the illusion that these wrestlers are really going at it, beating the shit out of each other. In this match, the incision was done incorrectly, which caused excessive bleeding. After this, Koulis was hospitalized and received 50 stitches. New Jack was charged with aggravated assault for this incident, but he was acquitted. Koulis sued New Jack and ECW for damages in July of 1998, but lost the case. Koulis unfortunately died in May of 2002 at the age of 22 due to complications from gastric bypass surgery. After this, his parents attempted to sue New Jack because they felt their son's death was caused by depression and a major eating disorder that they believed happened because of what New Jack did to him. This was the first in a series of incidents of New Jack bringing brutal real-life violence to professional wrestling. Fast forward to April of 2003, New Jack is working on the independent pro wrestling circuit and is booked in a match with veteran wrestler Gypsy Joe, who was 69 at the time. For unknown reasons, Joe kept no-selling all of New Jack's moves. This is where a wrestler is not putting in any effort to make another wrestler's attacks look effective. New Jack got frustrated because of this and felt that the only way for Joe to sell his attacks is if he legitimately started attacking him. New Jack began to attack 69-year-old Gypsy Joe with a chain, a baseball bat wrapped in barbed wire, and best of all, a framed picture of his aunt. The crowd were horrified over this, and some of them chose to leave the show in disgust, while the others stayed and continuously screamed the N-word at New Jack. Wrestling fans, man. In a 2019 interview with Vice, New Jack said that the more the crowd called him the N-word, the angrier he got and the more he beat Joe up. In October of 2004, at an event near Jacksonville, Florida, New Jack was wrestling fellow wrestler William Jason Lane for the promotion Thunder Wrestling Federation. During this match, to New Jack's surprise, Lane began legitimately punching New Jack in the face. I don't know how this guy didn't get the memo about New Jack. Why would you punch New Jack in the face at this point? You're either really stupid or really racist. New Jack responded to this by getting out of the ring and going home. Nah, I'm just kidding. He took a knife out of his gear and stabbed the man 9 times. This wasn't a small blade either, so they can incorporate a bit of bleeding into the match. This was an actual big fucking knife. New Jack was charged with aggravated assault with a deadly weapon and aggravated assault to commit murder. These are just some of the stories that made New Jack known as wrestling's most feared man, and he will always be a legend of hardcore wrestling. He did it all, man. He wrestled on acid, he got his ass ate by Goldust's wife, and purposely fucked up his WWE tryout by talking to Vince McMahon when he was specifically told not to talk to Vince McMahon. None of these are jokes, he actually did all of these things. I want to say rest in peace to the man one last time, and that my thoughts are with his family and friends. I'll never forget being a young child and watching clips of New Jack beat several people close to death on YouTube, and finding the reactions of the crowd who couldn't tell if it was part of the show or not fucking hilarious. Goodbye, New Jack. We'll miss you.
Hold on. No, fuck you.
It's a prop.
It ain't real?
It's a prop. It's a prop. It's not real.
You sure?